Yo, YouTube, what's happening, good people? What's happening? We back. We checking in with it. You know what I'm saying? I ain't dropped my first load yet. But peep this out. This is my first load. So after I got the truck, after I tried to get a load, got to the load. The thing is, the load wasn't ready. It was a tight load, whatever like that. So it took longer than expected. So I went over, I grabbed another load. So this load right here, pick up. And let me go ahead and see, because this load was 126 empty miles. See, from my first one, when my first load wasn't ready, so they went ahead and they paid me off $500 for it. It was called like Trek and Not Use or something like that. So I did hit 100 miles. The load wasn't ready. They paid me $500. I did hit it 2 hours, which was 126 miles. The load itself is 617 miles. So with this load, this load pays me. Oh, it's going to Home Depot in Austin and Home Depot in Douglasville. It came from Wheeler, Ohio, MTD Products. It's only like 24,000 pounds, so it's not heavy at all. I'm not burning much fuel. I only put about $200 worth of fuel in here. So let's run a few numbers to see how much I done made off of this one load. All right, before we get to the load, do y'all want to do the load first? You know what I'm saying? I'm just not turning my other phone on. I don't really be using it like that. But let's see. This load right here paid me off of 6, 7. Let's just say 750 miles. That's something about right, don't it? 126 and I'm going through this with y'all, so you know what I'm saying. 126, so it's 13, and that's 4. 743 miles, paying $3,391.70. That's how much for the line haul. But we get paid 65% of the load. The thing is, if you go ahead and get a leasing company, you know, that $10,000 and take USA off of your lease, then you'll end up getting 80%. I think it's between 75 and 80%. If you know, drop in the comment section, correct me if you know. So I end up getting 65% of that. So we're gonna do the math real quick. If I get 65%, I don't know who that is, but 65% of $3,391.70. That put me at $2,204.60, plus the fuel surcharge, which is $150, $2,354.60. You get the whole 100% of your fuel surcharge. So I just did the math on that. That's what I will bring home after one load. That's one load. $2,354.60. One load. 743 miles. I just told y'all. I just walked through this whole little thing. So that's what I get. So then we're gonna subtract. We don't have truck payments for 3 weeks. So I'm gonna subtract the $210 that I done put in the tank. That's still $2,144.60. So my next, well, let's add, even if we was to go back, add the $500 that they just gave me. For the truck to not use. So $500, that put me back $2,644.60. And then we gonna add the detention that they gave to me. So that's $2,809.60. So I should be looking something around this number. I make sure I do an update. If my number's wrong, then they just gonna be wrong. But this is what I'm adding up right now. So y'all walk through this with me, you know what I'm saying? This is what I'm getting. So I'll be paying insurances. So I think my insurance is like around 120. That still put me like $2,689. I'm walking through this the way I'm thinking because of what they done told me or whatever like that. So let's just hope and pray that this is what it's gonna be or whatever like that. Or somewhere in that range. I don't care if it's $2,000. Just show me how the whole breakdown is. I'll let y'all know how the breakdown is. And we're going to continue to move forward through this process. You hear me? So, my truck is $151,000. God dang, boy. brand new, $151,000. You gotta remember, my house was $161,000. So, no, my house was $166,000. So this ain't too far from it. $48,000 buyout, 4-year lease, $690 a week. So my thing is, even if I go back to this board and I only pull one load, this one load, and then I got $2,689. So let's just subtract. We already subtracted the insurance. We already subtracted the fuel. So let's just say I had a truck note, $690. That still put me at $1,999.60. We running through the math together, like right now. So I ain't messing with no numbers or nothing like that. If you want to follow along, you can. So that's still right at $2,000 off of one load. All your expenses done came out. You good to go. You know what I'm saying? You good to go. We done subtracted the fuel and all that we done use or whatever like that. So it is a 4-year lease for it, $48,000 buyout. They said you can finance that buyout. But the whole plan behind this is to run, get the decent money, the decent checks, all that. I got homeboys that's making $3,000, $4,000, $26,000, $23,000, barely even doing any work, to be honest. I'm talking about under 2,000 miles. You know what I'm saying? I will be adding my homeboys to this channel. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to bring them on here just so that they can show y'all better than I can show you, because I just started this. Y'all follow me from US Express over to USA, and we're going to try to make this happen. So, by looking at the whole breakdown, if your truck averages $5,000 a week, you can take home $3,000 a week. But the whole thing is to run less miles and make more money. You do not want your truck to make anything under $2 a mile. That's just keeping it real. You do not want your truck to make under $2 a mile. If it do, no lower than $170 a mile. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm digging it so far. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like when whatever you do, they pay you for it. They prompt, like, hey, my load, the load ain't ready. All right, let me get a contact. All right, boom. They hit you back 5 minutes later. Hey, you know what I'm saying? They said, give them until such and such. Like, whatever. Do you want to sit on the load? Do you want to grab another load? Like, what do you want to do? You your own boss. I told them straight up, pulled me off the load, but I couldn't find nothing else. So, like, they put me back on it. Later on that night, they was like, all right, cool. We're going to go ahead and switch you, find you a load. My homeboy hit me up, like, hey, bro, drop that load, go get this load. I'm like, all right, bet. When he got the load, right now, I'm in Tennessee. In the morning, I will deliver. I chill the weekend, deliver the second half Monday. So technically, if I just averaged out a little bit over $2,500 to the truck, then that means I still end up making $500 a day. It's kind of like where you want to be at. If you're staying out like that, you can make more. But I'm saying minimum $500 a day. That's going easily out of a 5-day week, 25, 6-day, 3,000, 7-day, 3,500. It's probably what to do it. My thing is, y'all just keep following your ball. We're going to keep, you know what I'm saying, progressing through this thing. Ain't no quitting. Ain't no giving up. It's going to be upgrades with this truck. It's going to be a whole bunch of other little stuff. The thing is, I did have a stability control light to come on my dashboard. So I most definitely got to get that checked out and see what's going on with that, because we do not need no problems in the beginning of this lease. I thank y'all. I appreciate y'all for checking in with your boy. It's just a quick little video. We're going to drop back on something soon. It's time to go to bed, slide out, and I love y'all.